something years ago. But yeah, I just noticed that.
Let's bring the meeting to order.
Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
We don't have to say it.
We have some meeting minutes to approve. Would have been our June 26th. That would have been our council workshop minutes. Have any additions or corrections? If not, on that workshop, I will share this.
Oh, were you? He was. Perfect. We can name up here.
We're going to have to test you.
I don't remember anything that was said.
Are there any other additions or corrections? If not, make a motion and have those approved.
I make that motion.
Motion on the floor by Stephanie. Second by Dave.
Since you were there.
Aye.
Signified by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed. Carried unanimously. We had also had our June 26th regularly scheduled council meeting minutes. Have any additions or corrections there? If not, make a motion and have those.
I suppose Dave was at that one too then.
I was.
But I was on that one.
Oh, that, yep, you are, okay.
No, I don't know.
I'll make that one.
Motion on the floor by Kyle.
I'll say.
Second by Mike. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed.
Who would not worry about?
Carried unanimously. Agenda this evening?
I do not have any additions or deletions at this time. Do you guys have something you want to add?
Maybe slots and.
We have a very short agenda this evening, so I guess we'll take it as is. I will need a motion to have the agenda approved.
I'll make a motion to approve the agenda.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
I'll second.
Second by Stephanie. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed. Carried unanimously. Building permits this evening?
We don't have any.
There is Andy Maher's 304 Car Street for a new dwelling. That wasn't approved from the last meeting, I don't think yet. But you guys approved it.
Andy Maher, no, we went over there?
Yeah, we approved it. Oh, yeah, you guys.
Yep.
We didn't. I'm sorry.
No, I was going to say it. I don't remember anything coming through and I've seen a backhoe over there.
Well, we can't help it. We're only 2 weeks slow, you know?
It's like, well, I know my memory isn't as good as.
That or Dave bought a backhoe and parked it next to it. I wasn't sure which one. Playground.
So that's one we need to, planning and zoning approved it, so.
And so did the building inspector.
Building official is, did as well. Then we will need a motion to have that approved as well.
I'll make that one.
Motion on the floor by Dave.
Here.
Second. Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Opposed. Carried unanimously. Next item on the agenda is Legion Park. Club.
I believe the Lions Club wanted to come and speak to you guys about the.
Hi, folks.
Hi.
I think Bob needs to come up here too.
Yeah, come on, you guys, bring up a couple chairs and.
We got, we're on chairs here, we're fine.
We're good.
But this came up because a week and a half ago, 2 weeks ago, you discussed the Legion Park, the slide and that whole issue. And it appeared that you were coming up short on money. I mean, like, it might be delayed for another year.
Probably next year.
And the Lions thought that that's a well-used park. We have several people that live in that area. And that maybe if we would throw in some dollars, we could encourage the city to get right on it and do it this summer as soon as you could. And so the board discussed it their last meeting a week and a half ago and said that if we would give $5,000, maybe the city would be encouraged to look for more money and get enough to get on it right away.
That's so awesome.
And so.
Wow.
So the board voted for $5,000 for the new swing set, slide set for the thing. And I assume our regular members will go along with that. We have to vote on it at our next meeting next week, but they've always come up in the past, so I don't see why they would.
Did you folks have anything specific in mind you wanted to see us get?
No, we have complete faith in Bob here.
No pressure, Bob.
And he's been looking at some things, I'm aware of that.
$5,000 goes a long way towards a new tire swing.
Yeah, as long as it has a slide on it, you're in trouble. But anyhow, we know it costs considerably more than that.
Yeah, there's.
And I understand Bob was looking at other options also to get some additional money.
Okay.
And so we just, our real reason at that time to come here was, instead of trying to delay it for a year, saying, delaying it next year isn't gonna make it any cheaper, and it's just unused for a year, and the money's gonna have to come from someplace anyhow, so we feel that it should be done this year. I mean, as soon as it can be done, as soon as Bob had time to do it, and you guys give him the money.
Well,
there you go.
First of all, on behalf of the council, I'd like to say thank you so very, very much. A great organization.
As long as we're on this update, because I see that we have to approve a couple of grants, is that for
yes.
the playground equipment?
Correct. So we applied for two NJPA grants. They're matching grants, so it's a total of $5,000. So we would receive $5,000, and the city would have to match $5,000 as well to receive that grant. And O'Carry applied for it, too, was working with Anna Gruber. So she helped us through that. And we also have, I think it was like 5,100 of NJPA dollars that we can use towards the playground equipment as well. So.
The NJPA dollars come from, when we purchase through NJPA, we actually get credit in dollars as well from some of the equipment we bought in the past. So that's up to 5,100.
Something like that. It's been some change. So
we should be able to put up
pretty. So we've got 5,000 from the Legion. We've got from the Lions, we've got 5,000 NJPA plus the 5,100 plus another 5 for us to match. So we should be able to build a little playground.
And we're still waiting to hear from the insurance company.
So we haven't heard from them. We haven't heard anything.
Well, they should be sometime this week, I'm hoping. So they were on, she was on vacation. So
Bob looks like he's got plans in his hand.
We don't have plans tonight, but I'd like to go through it with the Public Works Committee, just finalize a couple pieces that I've looked at. Probably about 22,000 is kind of what I'm looking at. That would put everything in compliance. We'd redo the surfacing too. ADA compliant surfacing now is manufactured wood chips. It's like a plastic
instead
wood
of sand.
Chip instead of sand.
So you can use
splinters. So everything would be up to ADA standards if we did it all at one time. That's what I would prefer.
It would be plastic wood chips, right?
Basically manufactured plastic wood chips.
You know, kids can walk on it and all that stuff.
And sand is nice, but
yeah.
We've got weeds growing in it now. That's one of the negatives, but you know, for ADA, sand isn't acceptable.
So yeah,
the 5,000 out of pocket from the city, and then that would leave us with 2,000.
I think Kara's applied for a Minnesota Power Grant as well, so we're just waiting to hear back from that. So.
Could we go ahead as a Public Works Committee and Bob approve, ratify something, go ahead and get it ordered already, and then deal with the insurance as it,
and the grants,
you know,
get them up to 25,000 or whatever, to not go above that?
For now.
For now?
Anything above 22,000 you would cover.
Yeah. Listen, my kids use at least that much of that playground. I can guarantee
it. We live over there too. It's a fabulous park.
It has been awesome.
Yeah. No, thanks again very much, Lance. Greatly, greatly appreciate it. But let's get this into record. So let's get a motion to approve the Lions Club grant.
I make a motion that we accept the $5,000 donation from the Lions Club.
Motion on the floor by Stephanie.
I'll second it.
Seconded by Mike. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 And that is for specifically for that playground or park.
Right. Motion carried.
Can we get two separate ones for the NJPA?
Are we just applying for that right now?
No, we've been awarded it.
Let's do those.
motion that we accept the first $2,500 NJPA grant towards the Legion Park here.
I'll second that.
Motion on the floor by Stephanie and second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously.
I'll make a motion that we accept the second $2,500 grant from NJPA.
Motion on the floor by Mike.
I'll second it.
Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Opposed, carried unanimously.
And then should we make a motion that Public Works can go ahead and plan it?
Yeah, let's do that.
Do we want to go, they've got.
Give them the $25,000 for now.
Up to $25,000.
Come back to the next meeting and.
So, I'll make a.
Insurance will cover this. What we overspend, Dave.
There you go.
Insurance.
So I make a motion that Public Works committee goes ahead and plans out the new playground equipment for the Legion Park not to exceed $25,000 without coming back to the council.
That's for purchase to stuff or just?
Yes.
Okay. Motion on the floor by Stephanie.
I'll second.
Going $25,000. Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed, carried unanimously. Thanks again, guys.
Geez, it only takes, you know, 5 minutes to spend $25,000. Thanks, guys.
Thank you again, guys.
Thank you guys for everything you did.
And don't forget to buy brats. We got two more sales.
Two more sales, we'll make sure we stop for that.
Thanks again. Thank you.
Looking at the Initiative Foundation contribution request for $2,000. And they actually asked for that number, they just asked for.
Just a commitment, so this is what was this in December.
What did we give?
It's the same, $14,450. We did that 16 and 7.
Yeah. $14.50.
Yep, $14.50.
I make a motion that we donate $1,450 to the Initiative Foundation for 2018.
Very good. Motion on the floor by Mike.
I'll second it.
Second by Dave. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Aye, opposed, carried unanimously.
Initiative Foundation doesn't have any grants for playground equipment, do they?
We get naked, you know?
If we come up short, which with the insurance I doubt we will, but if we come up short, can we go to the fire relief?
Yeah, absolutely. We could certainly approach the Fire Relief Association if we come up a little short.
And the Freedom Fest is this weekend, so I mean, there was talk of, at the Freedom Fest committees already, of donating towards the city for some playground stuff last year.
They decided to do that, Mike. We could use a little bit of stuff done at the other park as well.
Yeah, right, and that's what.
If they decide they want to do that.
And usually we don't have the final numbers on Freedom Fest until probably the end of August before all the bills are paid and everything, where we get a final number and then go from there.
I'll show you this too here. I was forwarded something from somebody that says it's, we were going to maybe follow up on it, and Scott resigned shortly after it. It's Thriving Communities Program through the Initiative Foundation.
Okay, yeah.
So I don't know what the details exactly are, but there's an application process that could allow the city to close to $15,000 to use towards special projects.
Perfect, yeah.
But, yeah, I'll have to look into the details of that.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
So, I just remembered that I got that.
Get that with a call, and she can research that. Good, thanks, Kyle. We have some department reports. Public Works, Bob?
Looks like there's only one department here.
Phone and calls there.
She's always your.
We could throw Lynn in for first response.
Got your paperwork for your annual report?
Yeah. Update on Edward Street, Third Avenue project. Last fall, the contractor put topsoil in, and it didn't meet the spec. It was more of a black sand. They ended up seeding it last fall. We told them it didn't meet spec, it needs to be replaced, so that's been done here last week. They came in, took the old black dirt out, put the black dirt in, and reseeded it with hydro seed. SEH sent out a letter, a newsletter to the residents around there, just reminding them they're responsible for the water. So, it's unfortunate, it's a bad time here in the city, but that's kind of what we're stuck with, so. We have good material in there, just hopefully they'll see.
I hope it's good material, will hold the moisture a little better, and it should take a lot better to tie up, so you can cover it.
Other than that, we demoed a system for electric theory. It's actually the last company we sent, this is basically the same contractor that Minnesota Power uses. So I put out 4 meters, about 10 corners of town, and did a little demo with them. So they've got a drive-by unit, you just put in your vehicle, it's about a $5,000 drive-by unit. Put a little GPS thing on a dash, drive around. So it was about 2 to 5 blocks away, it was starting to pick these things up.
So really?
I mean, it was pretty impressive. The stuff on the office end, and within minutes, we get it in, you know, tomorrow. So it was a good demo.
Something you're looking to pursue, or?
Well, we're real close on putting everything together, so kind of it's gonna be timed pretty well with that playground equipment. And just kind of do that at the same time, I think, with the Public Works Electric Committee, kind of hash through those options.
Okay.
On the meter reading.
Okay.
And then come up with the recommendations to the council on that, so.
Okay. Sounds good.
Yeah.
See if yourself a pair of shoes is over the next year here.
Yeah.
And frozen toes this winter.
There's pluses and minuses too, you know, just get a tree crew out, trim a tree study. When I'm reading meters, I can really check those backyards for tree trimming, and I can make notes. So there's pluses and minuses with water and everything too.
If there's an easier, more efficient way to go about doing it, you know, something you wanna pursue, and the council wants to go along with it, I'd be real interested in taking a look at it, and check these guys out too.
So I'm thinking within the next couple of weeks, that playground stuff, and the meters.
Sounds good.
Thanks, Bobby.
Nicole?
Sure, so I saw a few things. I've been working with Schlinger Water for a mid-year review to make sure our accounts and payroll are up to snuff and where they need to be. So I was just seeing if you guys would mind approving, if we have them come in and check out to make sure we're on task and we're not gonna have anything. I'm assuming that there's gonna be a charge that haven't given me a quote or anything, but I just think it would be nice to make sure we're not at the end of the year again trying to figure out stuff and coming to 2 hours before they're due and stuff like that, so.
If you cut it in the budget, I think it's well within our while. I don't want to have to go through even half of what we did last year.
You're right.
And see, it was a nightmare, so.
Now we've got the new system online for.
Now we've got the new system, maybe, you know, this year do another water. If we're confident after that, we can skip it, but.
Yeah, definitely. I just wanna make sure that we're moving forward in the right direction and not going back to phases.
Lot easier to fix now than it is.
Oh, boy, at the end of the year, when it's crunch time, and you gotta have it in, you know.
Yeah, I think it's a good idea.
Sometimes it's easier to fix it than it do than try and fix a whole year's worth of.
And I don't foresee it being too bad.
So, yeah, if we're not fully comfortable or confident yet in.
I don't feel like we're way behind or anything like that, but I just wanna make sure that we're on task and putting things where they need to be, and we're, our W-2s aren't.
Well, I wrote it all over at some place. No, that's fine. You guys are okay.
Yeah, just authorize her to go ahead and do it.
Yeah. Well, except she's got the money in her budget.
Correct.
Go ahead.
Okay, perfect. I'll definitely double check that. Okay, otherwise I just have a few updates. Freedom Fest is this weekend, starting at 2 p.m. Just gonna let everybody know about that. Awesome.
Yeah.
In case you didn't know.
That starts Thursday night from here, right?
The off-sale liquor license holders can now sell off-sale on Sundays from 11 to 6 p.m. if they so choose. And the city does not have to change anything with our city ordinance, so we're good to go with that.
So they don't need to come reapply for anything?
Nope, it was just with their license, off-sale license.
Yeah, because I've seen some no
125th City Celebration Golf Scramble is Thursday, July 20th at 3 p.m. at Pierce Golf Course. If anyone is interested, they can sign up here at City Hall.
We are going to.
It's a four-person team, so.
I talked to some people on the park board, and we are going to throw a team together for that, too, so.
Perfect.
I'll stop you tomorrow and register for it.
Are we getting some teams?
Yeah, we do have a few, yeah. It's just nice, we're getting down to, what is it, a week, yeah, so we can have. And we do, I'm going to schedule the property planning committee meeting on Monday, July 31st at 5:30. It is not a council meeting, I figure that's, it's still Monday, but it's not going to be, there was that time we had three or four different meetings scheduled and committees scheduled all at once here, so it was kind of a.
Chaos.
Yeah, so it'd be kind of nice to do it, still on a Monday, but not on council Monday.
Sure, we keep everybody.
When is that going to be?
31st, if that works for everybody. I believe we're supposed to have our drawings prepared, what ideas we have for the property.
Yeah, everybody was handed a little sheet.
A little map.
Yeah, a little map, so. Where's their breakdown there, wants, is there? What they think it should look like in the future, so.
It'll be a map, but.
I was going to say, we don't have the engineer involved yet, so.
No.
Nobody wants the hay.
Nobody wants the hay.
Not yet, anyways.
There's not enough out there.
No, Todd had, I mean, it would be nice to have it cut, but I guess if we can't find anybody to take it, we'll just wait until spring.
Another fire practice, burner off again, and then next year we need to dip. After, I would say after we burn it next year, we need to start.
Doing something.
Doing something, you know, cleaning up the rocks or leveling, doing something, you know. No matter what the plan is going to be, we need to do general maintenance out there of the property, so.
I would like to see that.
Yeah. You want to get rid of thistles in your backyard.
Still got to bring up a complaint with Bobby.
But again, you're the meat inspector, so.
Yeah, that's after you.
And we'll put our heads together, get out some thistles.
They got sprayed today.
They got sprayed today?
Oh, did they?
Yeah.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
There, see?
Yeah. Way ahead of the game, yeah, Bobby. Bob just kind of snuck up on that deal, next thing you know, it was done, yeah.
Yeah, well, that, appreciate it. I think the rest of the residents will do, they're getting out of control back there.
Yeah.
Are they flowering yet, Bob, or?
They're ready to start.
Starting to blow yet, but they definitely.
They're starting, yeah.
But he did leave the ones in your yard. He left the ones in your yard, though.
Yeah, it was nice.
I love it.
No, I specifically told Bob, and yeah. The guy was out there, and it looks like he did a really nice job.
Those things are tall.
He hit it, yeah. And they're hard to kill, I tell you, I usually spray them twice a year, and you can kill them next spring or right back. You just can't control them, I don't know what the answer is.
You can dig them out by hand, one by one.
I don't even have that help out.
We burnt those out there, and, wow, right along.
Couldn't get close to the fence, that was the issue.
The contractor said today to hit them again in the fall, I've got them coming to do other stuff.
Okay.
If you spray them broadleaves in the fall, they're taking their nutrients down, so they'll take that chemical down to their roots and.
And they'll, yeah, another one is that, that burning nettle, that burn weed, that stuff's the same way, you just can't kill that stuff either.
Yeah, that stuff's kind of mixed in there too.
It's tough.
I don't know, it seems like the last couple of years, it just really just expanded and took off.
Yeah. Anybody else have anything?
That's all that I have for my report.
No bills or anything to pay this month?
Oh, yeah, now she's the treasurer, now she's the treasurer.
We have a checkbook balance of $999,231.91.
I make a motion that we accept that, okay?
Motion on the floor to accept the treasurer's report.
I'll second it.
Motion made by Steph and seconded by Dave, all those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
Aye.
Aye, opposed. Carried unanimously, claims for the month. Anybody have any questions on claims? Not only motion to pay the bills.
I'll make a motion that we pay the claims.
I
second it.
Second by Mike. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Aye. Opposed? Carried unanimously. Anybody have anything else?
I make a motion to adjourn this meeting.
There is a motion on the floor to adjourn. That's definitely.
I'll second it.
Second by Kyle. All those in favor, please signify by stating aye.
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 Opposed? Carried unanimously.
We need it.
Thank you very much.
You guys make it hard to find a frickin' story.
There's really not.